Hi, Cyberint, now a checkpoint company, is the market leader in external risk management, which is the combination of cyber threat intelligence, attack surface management, brand protection, and supply chain intelligence into a single comprehensive solution. In this short video, we will dive into our external attack surface management capabilities. First thing our attack surface management module does is identify all the internet-facing assets that are associated with an organization. To do this, we simply need one seed asset, typically a main company domain. We can enter the information and start a discovery scan. Once the scan is complete, we then have an initial idea of the organization's external attack surface. This process identifies many externally facing assets. This could be a domain, a subdomain, an externally facing IP address, or a certificate. The assets discovered all have a confidence score. This is based on the discovery technique and reflects chances that the asset is indeed owned or controlled by the organization. In addition, each asset has its own asset card. This provides information around how the asset was discovered, as well as any exposures detected for and any alerts associated with that asset. In this example, this asset belongs to a company domain which was registered by an Office 365 associated domain which was registered by a company email. This allows an organization to understand the history and the context of each asset. Assets are identified in a number of ways. This could be through WHOIS data, DNS records, certificates, or cloud infrastructures. Assets that are discovered that have a lower confidence score are left unvalidated, though customers can configure the confidence level at which assets are validated or left unvalidated for manual review. I'm going to zoom into our discovery process in a more visual way. Step 1. We start by inputting your primary assets. But we don't stop there. Step 2. The solution automatically discovers additional relevant assets. We use various discovery techniques and end up finding many more assets. Step 3. The process occurs again. Step 4, and again until all possible assets are found. Step 5 and 6. The first two assets above a defined confidence level are automatically approved and validated. Step 7. But the subsequent asset's confidence level falls below the threshold. Step 8. Here, validation occurs. Step 9. Once the next asset is validated, the following assets are too. This allows the customer to review each asset and decide whether they want to bring them into the scope for monitoring or not. These are classed as unvalidated assets, and we provide a summary of the primary assets that should be reviewed. This allows the customer to understand the association of the discovered asset back to the parent company, and they can determine whether they want to validate this asset for future monitoring. This, of course, is an iterative and continuous process. By validating discovered assets, the discovery scan is rescheduled, meaning we continuously find new assets that may be deployed without proper approval. In other words, shadow IT. Once we have an understanding of the assets, we can start to understand which of those assets are at most risk or vulnerable. Each asset is assigned a risk level, from low to very high. This allows an organization to very quickly reduce their risk by prioritizing and remediating the most critical issues among their internet-facing assets. As you can see, this demo organization has 7 assets that have very high severity alerts attached to them. The customer can click within an alert in reference to a specific asset to understand the risks associated. In this instance, a vulnerable technology has been detected. Because the ASM module has fingerprinted the software and version number that's running, we know there is a CVE related to this technology and can issue an alert along with additional data about the CVE. A common question is, how likely is this CVE to be exploited? To help answer this question, we provide vulnerability intelligence, which includes all activity observed across the open, deep, and dark web on every documented CVE. We add relevant tags, such as exploitation in the wild, availability to exploit code, and other important risk indicators. Using all this data, we assign a risk score to each CVE to help organizations understand which should be prioritized for remediation. Another feature we offer is active exposure validation. This allows an organization to go beyond typical CVE detection to actively test vulnerabilities for exploitability using advanced automation. Active exposure validation also performs other automated tests to uncover common security issues in your organization's digital assets that fall outside the scope of a vulnerability database. Every environment is given a posture score. This gives the customer a clear understanding of their current risk across the entire attack surface. The score is based on a number of different factors, including how long an organization takes to acknowledge and remediate risk, how exposed are they in comparison to similar organizations, and how severe are the risks associated to the assets that they own. Typically, our customers have a posture score of an A or a B because we've worked collaboratively to help them reduce their risk, solve their vulnerabilities, and therefore improve their security posture. Watch our other recorded demos to better understand all of Cyberint, now a Checkpoint company's capabilities, and contact us for a deep dive analysis on your organization.